Yeah, frustrated, but never mind what we thought of that part of the game. I thought we played a really solid game tonight as a group. I didn't think we gave them much. We'll look at some PK and get better that way. But I thought we played very sound structurally, and I thought it was one of our most complete games this year.
How important is it coming out of a game like this, or really on any night, for you guys to focus on process over results so early in the season?
Honestly, I think the guys and we're doing a really good job. It's just taking it day by day. We're not worried about our record, whether we're doing well, winning a game, losing a game. We come in and we try and get better at the things that we need to get better at, and try and get more consistent with it is a big thing for our group. But tonight was, even though we didn't get our extra point, it was a good game for us.
Take a double monitoring. You hit the ball, the puck on the wall. Just walk us through what happened from both your own blue line.
I think they missed a pass or something, and I was able to jump on it, and I think they, had a lot of their momentum going into our zone, so I was able to, jump in, get a, an odd man break, and was fortunate enough to put it in.
How important was it for you guys to perform that way, especially on the second half of a back-to-back?
It was good. It's good for our group. When we went up 2-1, then they tied it, and then went up 3-2. I think we've come a long way in terms of how we handle even that situation right there. We stuck with it. It was a good game at the end, and I thought we deserved better.
Long road trip, come back, beat St. Louis. I thought we deserved better tonight. We gave them nothing other than the 2-5-on-3. So I hope the guys take a nice relaxing day tomorrow, as they deserve it.
You come in after a finish like that. Is it hard not to, express your frustration, I suppose?
Yeah, I mean, it's 82 games, right? You're going to have these type of games where, things happen. So, but I like the resolve of the team. I really do. I mean, scoring that, it's 3-2. We could have hung our hat, been mad, but Susk with a big goal for us. Fans were into it, so overtime was great. So that's the way I look at it right now.
The first period, it felt like you guys maybe looked a bit slow, given that you played the night before. How did you see the first period?
Yeah, we just tried to stay. I don't know. They only had 12 shots after two periods, so whether we were slow or not, if you don't have your legs, you manage the game. I thought we managed the game.
When you think about the offense that you're getting from the defensemen of recently, last season, this wasn't happening. How different is it this year with these guys?
Yeah, they're being calculated, jumping in the play, doing a nice job. Obviously, Mizey thought he played great tonight. What a hell of a goal. And then, Seuss. So when you can get some goals from your back end in 82 games, it's obviously something you want, right? Helps you in the standings.
And another game where Nils Höglander seems to be playing the style that you want from him. What do you think from him tonight?
Yeah, once again, we had it's especially teams in the first period, so those guys get kind of lost sometimes. But I like his energy, buzzing around, being the forechecker there. That's an identity that we need, and he can supply that for us. So he did a nice job on the forecheck.
What was your view of the too many men in the third period?
Yeah, it's a tough one. Listen. I remember I was working for TNT, and Don Koharski's a buddy of mine. I said, I could ref in this league. I can't ref in this league. It's a hard job. I played, 18 years in the NHL thinking I know hockey, and it's tough. It's tough out there. It's bang-bang plays. These guys are working their asses off the refs. I get it. Sometimes they're going to make mistakes, just like I make mistakes in the players. So it's a tough one. I thought it was a good game. Those are the ones. You see that a lot, where a guy's 3 feet from the bench, but he felt that, that was the right call. So, we're going to live with it.
What did you think of the play of your goaltender tonight?
Casey?
Yeah.
Casey. Yeah, he played really well. Their goalie played great too. I mean, it was a chess match tonight. There wasn't a lot. We didn't give him much. 5-on-5, I didn't see much. They didn't get much. They got the 2 5-on-3s and the power play. That was the difference in the game. Kind of.
Over the last handful of games, it seems like your team's 5-on-5 game has really started to build and trend positively. What are a couple areas or keys to sort of finding that 5-on-5 game lately?
Just chipping away. Like I said, after the Philly game, if you look at our games, we've just gotten better and better, believe in what we're doing. I think we're creating an identity here, around here. There's some resolve and, you know, everybody's contributing. You know, even that guys that don't get out there for 8 minutes, they get out there and they're doing something for us. So, it's nice. I'm glad the guys, they need a day off tomorrow for sure.
It seemed to mostly be a low event game for a lot of it, but there were still some puck management things that came into play. I'm thinking like Hoglander with 4 seconds left, icing the puck, or Pronick clearing the puck over the glass when he had time to make a play. Are those just some of those little things that you need to iron out to get a more steady approach to the season?
Yeah, I mean, you know, those things happen. Yeah, you obviously you don't want to see a lot of that. I haven't seen a lot of that stuff, you know. Yeah. Guys are tired. You know, when you're tired, that's the, you know, you really got to dig in, you know, on those plays. But yeah, they happen. We're okay with that.
So getting Ilya Mikheyev back on the penalty kill, is that kind of the plan for you guys in the return? Because I think tonight was the first time he was back on the penalty kill for you guys.
Yeah, I just want to manage, you know, coming off that surgery, I want to make sure that, the other guys are doing a nice job. I want to ease them into it. And then when Giuseppe went in, a couple of guys went in the box, Lafferty, you know, that's the time I want to use him. But I'm kind of managing his minutes. So with his knee and stuff, I want to, you know, the guy just came off surgery and stuff, and he's healthy. I just want to make sure he's okay.
Is it something you have to manage? Like with the back to back, how are you feeling about how you guys managed his return to the lineup here from, like you mentioned, a surgery?
Yeah, I mean, the poor guy, you know, he hasn't really had a training camp, right? And so that's why, you know, he's going to have some rusty games. But, you know, obviously it's his speed, and playing back to back is tough for him, you know, being off so long.
And I just wanted to ask you quickly, you mentioned the fans.
That standing ovation at the end of regulation. Does that feel like sort of a vote of confidence that you're getting buy-in from the people over how things are going so far this year?
Feels good. I mean, you know, we need them behind us. You know, I think they want to believe in something, and we're trying to make them believe in something. And I think the guys did a nice job for them to believe in us.